I did not ask Betsy DeVose to take the job as Secretary of Education. Nor did I counsel her that she should go on 60 Minutes and submit her agenda to the prying eyes of people who would never give her a chance to talk about what she's going to do to make public schools in this better, public schools in this country a little bit better. That's what she did last night on 60 Minutes. Predictably, the next day, the entire media universe, like sharks, were circling around, telling everybody what a lousy job she did, how she's the most hated member of the Trump administration, and how she blew every single question. Now, most of the questions that she blew, according to the reporters, we could just write that off as just a bunch of reporters down with the cause, don't know anything about what's going on, and blah, blah, blah. Except for one question. One question that we deal with here all the time. It's the question about black violence in schools, and whether it's wildly out of proportion. A question about black discipline in schools, and whether black students are being disciplined unfairly by their racist white teachers. We've exposed that as part of the greatest lie of this generation, the idea that somehow the only reason there are so many more black people getting suspended and expelled from schools is because of white racism and relentless white racism picking on black people all the time for no reason whatsoever. So that's what Lesley Stahl did last night. She served up a big, fat softball. Now remember, Betsy DeVos has been in this job for more than a year. They served her up a big, fat softball, and she didn't have the slightest idea how to answer the question.
Part of her job as Secretary of Education is overseeing guidelines that protect the civil rights of students. Just days after being confirmed, she rescinded a guideline implemented under President Obama that allowed transgender students to use the bathrooms of their choice, sparking even more protests. She's now considering scrapping the Obama-era guidance on how to identify, avoid, and remedy discriminatory discipline, which aims to prevent schools from punishing students of color more harshly than their white classmates.
We are studying that rule. We need to ensure that all students have an opportunity to learn in a safe and nurturing environment. And all students means all students.
Yeah, but let's say there's a disruption in the classroom. And a bunch of white kids are disruptive, and they get punished, you know, go see the principal. But the black kids are, you know, they call in the cops. I mean, that's the issue. Who and how the kids who disrupt are being punished.
Arguably, all of these issues or all of this issue comes down to individual kids. And
it does
come down to individual kids, and often comes down to I am committed to making sure that students have the opportunity to learn in an environment that is conducive to their learning.
Do you see this disproportion in discipline for the same infraction as institutional racism?
We're studying it carefully and are committed to making sure students have opportunity to learn in safe and nurturing environments.
While this regulation is under review, she's already drawn fire for changing.
So everybody in the Trump administration better figure this out, and they better figure this out in a hurry. The last 8 years of the Obama administration was spent looking at everything through the lens of race and white racism. Everything, especially the schools. I mean, they started that real early on. White racism is the only reason for this incredible level of black dysfunction in schools, whether it's discipline or academic achievement. Totally relieving black parents and black students of any responsibility for the ridiculous crime, violence, and dysfunction in these schools. You know, the kind of schools where 16 black schools in high schools in Baltimore, nobody can read above a third grade level. That's what we're talking about. And so Betsy's had 13 months. She hasn't heard about this before. She hasn't decided on it before. She's from Michigan. They said she's from Grand Rapids, Michigan, where her family apparently are big dogs up there. She doesn't know anything about Detroit or Grand Rapids or any of the other stories in black schools we've done in Michigan. Lesley Stahl says, oh, yeah, you know, when white kids do it, they just slap them on the wrist. When black kids do it, they call the police. So Betsy DeVos can't even say, oh, could you give me some videos of white kids acting out in school at the same level of black students? Could you give me some numbers on that? Can you give me some videos on that? Can you give me anything on that besides some phony baloney academic study done by a university that is down with the cause and against everything Trump and conservatives want to do? I mean, if Betsy DeVos says something, Lesley Stahl was going to jump all over her for making one assertion. Why couldn't Betsy look at her and say, well, Lesley, what are you talking about? I mean, it seems like the people who are suspended are misbehaving. If they're not misbehaving, could you please let me know? Because it seems like there's a whole bunch more people in these schools who should be suspended, who should be expelled. But because of the Obama administration's actions over the last 8 years, you remember the Excellence in African American Education executive order? You remember that one? Because of the Obama administration, every teacher in America knows they just simply cannot discipline black students without putting their career and job at risk. Betsy doesn't know, can't come up with a better answer than that after 13 months on the job. Did she think she was going to sweet talk Lesley Stahl? Did her advisors whisper in her ear that, yeah, let's just, you know, pretend like we don't know what that's all about and maybe Lesley Stahl will not notice? Well, here's a plain fact. There's a lot of bad stuff that has to be pulled up by the roots. A lot of weeds that have to be pulled up by the roots before Betsy DeVos and Trump have the slightest chance of making a difference in what's happening in our schools around the country. Does Betsy DeVos seem to you like she's the kind of person who's going to start pulling out these weeds? Or is it just the thing that Lesley Stahl was talking about? Seems like it's all talk. Wow, I hate to do this, but I think I might be agreeing with Lesley Stahl, because Lesley, like Betsy DeVos, they've learned their lesson well in whatever school they learned their little fairy tales of black victimization, and they learn very well. No matter what else you teach in that school, no matter what else happens in that school, no matter how much violence and dysfunction are in that school, no matter how many teachers are attacked in these schools, just don't do anything to make the black kids angry.